Hi guys, Mark here. I hope you're doing well. Today's tutorial is going to cover the process of making a skull pattern paracord key fob. The technique that we're going to be using originates from macrame. The cord that I'm going to be using for my project is microcord. For the background, you're going to need a single strand, 5.5 feet long. For the skull pattern, we're going to use 4 cords, each 2 feet long, and a single cord, 1 foot long. For the hardware, use either a lobster claw or a key ring. For the tying surface, you will want something that you can stick pins into, so a corkboard or perhaps cardboard. Finally, scissors and a lighter are going to perform our cutting and melting tasks. Let's begin. First, I'm going to plan my project out. I draw a rectangle, 9 squares in width, 11 squares in height. Then I draw in my pattern. I'm now going to transfer this pattern into practice. Now, let's set up our project for tying. First, tape down your tying surface. Pin down your piece of hardware. We now attach our cords onto the piece of hardware. First, the 4 cords, each 2 feet long. Fold each in half. Then attach it using our reverse lark's head knot. Then, take your cord 1 foot long. Pass your cord through your reverse lark's head knots then hatch it here on the right. Top down. Then through the loop. So a simple hatch. We now have 9 working chords. Take your last remaining chord. This one is 5.5 feet long. Again pass it through your reverse lark's head knots, plus through the single hatch here on the right. Tighten up your reverse lark's head knots, the hatch, in our pattern, an empty square means that we attach our long cord onto one of our working ends. A filled-in square means that we attach one of our working ends onto the long cord. As you can see, our first row is done completely by attaching our long cord onto the working ends. Since our cord here is on the right, we work from right to left. We tie a half hatch, tighten up, do a second half hatch, tighten up. Repeat 8 more times. The second row starts with two empty squares, then using our long cord. Then five filled-in squares, then using our working hands. We finish up with two empty squares, again done using our long cord. This time we work from left to right. So first, two double half hitches using our long cord. A half hitch, tighten up, a second half hitch, tighten up, do the next strand exactly the same way. So a half hitch, a second half hitch, tighten up. Then five double half hitches done using our working hands. So the first one, the second one, third one, fourth one, and the fifth one. Then another two double half hitches done using our long cord. The third row starts with an empty square, done using our long cord. Then we have seven filled-in squares, done using our working hands. We finish up our row with another empty square, again done using our long cord. The fourth row is done exactly the same way as the third one. It is just done from left to right. So we have an empty square, done using our long cord, 7 filled in squares, done using our working hands, and finally another empty square, again done using our long cord. Let's do one more row, the fifth one. An empty square, a filled in square, 2 empty squares, a filled in square, 2 empty squares, a filled in square, and finally another empty square. From right to left, So, the fifth row. From here on out, I'm going to demonstrate the rest of the key fob without explaining. Read and implement. To finish up, cut and meld the ends. So guys, that's our project. It takes a bit of time to do, but in my opinion the result is well worth it. Thank you for joining me, consider supporting the site on Patreon, and I'll see you next time.